remember when they first did boats.
This is the review for the Diamondback Hook 2017 mountain bike. A whole lot of bike for a budget price. I've been riding a lot of miles on this Diamondback Hook since I first bought it back in March 2017. Putting over 1,000 miles on it from Pennsylvania, New York, to New Jersey. I think it's time to express what I think about this bike. Not my first bike. I owned another hardtail previously before this bike, which was a Cannondale Catalyst. However, I felt like this first bike held me back a bit in my riding capability.
Oh shit!
You gotta be kidding me. Dude.
The 1x drivetrain system and slack geometry on the hook initially drove me to this bike as I wanted a more aggressive hardtail for my type of riding. And I got that hardtail without breaking the bank. This bike comes with all your modern tech and features you would expect from a modern mountain bike. It has disc brakes, a 1x drivetrain, a double buted 700mm plus Diamondback Pro bars, and 27.5-inch tires. As you can see, I have sticker slapped the hell out of the bike to customize the look. The most seasoned mountain bikers are wary of an under $1,000 hardtail bike like the Diamondback Hook because there's going to be parts the manufacturer usually cheaps out on. However, these parts aren't too much to replace and upgrade yourself. The most obvious drawback on the Diamondback Hook are the tires and the derailleur and gear range. The stock Kenda tires look like they're made out of cheap rubber compound, which makes them grip well in loose terrain, but not as much in hard-packed, chunky terrain. The derailleur is a stock entry-level SRAM X3. For your first bike, it's not a bad derailleur, but I've replaced it with an X7 within the first 2 weeks. I'm sure the X3 will still hold up with proper tuning and maintenance. The stock pedals are all right that come with the bike, besides the reflectors that are built into them, so I swapped them with the red Origin 8s off my previous bike. Also, the seat is really stiff and not comfortable at all, so I swapped it out with another seat from another bike. Another thing is the gear ratio, which seems like a cost cut is close to bare with the 1x and the 8-speed cassette setup. However, this is what you get for under $800. The hook gets the job done, as the more fit I become, the less I feel like this gear ratio holds me back from climbing. Since I bought the bike, I've been in the best shape of my life, every week getting faster, pedaling longer, and conquering new climbs. As of writing, I went from 6 miles in an hour and a half to 12 miles in an hour and a half with no brakes on my local cross-country trails. Another gripe I have with the bike is with all the modern components and tech like the wide bars, 1x drivetrain, 27.5-inch wheels, it's that the rims and the wheels are not tubeless ready. Not too much of a big deal with $20 rim tape will help your rims go tubeless. With the seat and pedal swapped out, the Diamondback Hook becomes a much greater bike. The bike comes with nice wide 750mm double-buted alloy Diamondback Pro handlebars. The rise and sweep are just enough for my liking. Also, the stem is nice and short as well, just the way I like it with wide bars. However, I felt like I had to cut a quarter of an inch of the bars in total, and the width is now just right for me, so I'm not clipping in the trees in the really narrow sections on my local trails at Allaire State Park. The cockpit of the bike is mostly in-house, first-party Diamondback parts, besides the Tektro brake levers. Back home around my house, I ride a lot of cross-country type trails. They're kind of flat with not much elevation. And this bike climbs, even with its slack geometry. I've conquered all my hometown climbs with this new bike, and it overall descends confidently. Even when it gets rowdy on the gnarly rock or root sections, the plush 120mm travel coil fork is just enough between too stiff or too cushy on a hardtail.
Yeah.
Also, the profile and the Kenna tires are knobby enough to find plenty of grip and carry speed. The knobs on the sides are raised higher for finding better grip on turns and flat corners. As a tip, take a little air out of your tires and you're more comfortable with, and you'll find much more grip. I've upgraded the tires over time to a fast rolling, specialized slaughterer in the rear and a knobby Bontrager expert in the front. This bike has everything I need to enjoy the trails, whether mellow or gnarly. I'd recommend a dropper post upgrade to make the ride more comfortable. I've taken this bike to the rugged mountains of central PA and the local trails around my town. 2017 Hook model was a bright orange color. I wasn't too crazy about it at first, but after the bike baked in the sun, it really pops out the color and it grew on me. Overall, this is a great entry-level mountain bike, whether this is your first or second bike like me. This borderline trail bike does it all, from climbing to descending and jumping. With its short chain stays and 68 degree head tube angle, it's a nimble, versatile mountain bike that feels balanced for all types of riding, from the uppity climbs and daring downhills. I don't feel like this bike holds me back at much at all now. For under $1,000, this is a superb trail weapon to explore the mountains, wilderness, or even the trails behind your house. If I could do it again, I'll replace my Cannondale with this bike any day. If you enjoyed this review, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a comment. I'd be happy to answer any questions you have down below. See you on the trails. Stay junky.
Fuck you and the 12 gears you rode in on. Wow, I made it up for the first time. Holy shit. And I'm a fat shit right now.